Hi, this is Bas from Veasy. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate the ReTrigger gated CV manipulator. You can find it under Utilities, Veasy, and there you'll find the ReTrigger. With the ReTrigger, you can manipulate as many CV values as you like over any device in the reason rack. I'll show you some examples. Right here, a drum sequencer player is playing a gong. The pattern triggers the first pad. The audio output is affected by an M-class equalizer. And with every pulse, the low shelf frequency changes just a little bit. But when I make the values differ more, you can see and hear the result. Let's find a nice spot by listening. And when I add a standard hi-hat, the beat just dances a bit more. Over here I added a matrix with a randomized pattern. Its CV cables are connected to an NXT sampler. I've added a few effects in its audio path, and as you can see, the sweeper's frequency knob moves a lot. The echo's feedback knob moves a bit. On the channel EQ, the high pass and low pass filter knobs move a lot. The pack 2's frequency knob goes wild, and the amp's power amp gain freaks out. All manipulated by the ReTrigger right here. Together it sounds like this. You decide whether you want to make subtle or drastic changes. The ReTrigger is equipped with 8 columns. Every column has an input section, 4 groups of manipulation, and an output section. At the input section, you can choose between CV plus MIDI, CV only, MIDI only, and block. When I hit my MIDI controller, you can see the MIDI LEDs blink bright green to inform you of incoming MIDI. And when I connect the gate output of a matrix, the ReTrigger receives CV input. I'll turn down the tempo so you can see that the ReTrigger gets input per note pulsed from the matrix. It's also possible to receive both CV and MIDI simultaneously. If that produces undesired results, you can change the input selector to, for example, CV only. The MIDI input will then be blocked for that column. Or you set it to MIDI only to block CV input. Or you can select block and no input will be handled by that column. The LED right here also informs whether a cable is connected or not. When no cable is connected, the LED is dimmed red. After connecting a cable, the LED turns dimmed green. And when it receives input, it blinks bright green. So when the column receives input, it triggers all 4 groups. When you press the Enable button, the group's output value is calculated. It uses the A and B value as parameters for the selected function to calculate the output shown in the output display. So when I change the A value to 16, for example, with every pulse a random value between and including 0 and 16 is generated. Of course, you can change the B value as well. You can bypass the function and hold the value for testing with a test button next to the value. The output will remain at that exact value. When you press both test buttons, the output value will alternate between values A and B. And when both buttons are not pressed, the selected function will be used. Beside random, you can also select up-down. Let's turn up the tempo a bit. Now you can see that the values increase or decrease by 1 and turn around when reaching the A or B value. Per pulse, you can turn on or off a maximum of 4 groups. When you need more groups, you can patch through internally. Make sure that the input selector of the column accepts CV. Or just add another ReTrigger and patch externally to add more groups. You can use Reset Device to go back to the default values. Or you can load a patch. Block means all input selectors of all columns are set to block. A patch with filled labels in the name turns all label captions into the name of that section. Blank labels erases all label captions. When you control click a value, the value resets to its default value. When you hold shift while dragging, the values change at a slower pace to set the value more precise. As you can see, the gate of the matrix is connected to the input of column A. And because the same value is outputted at patch out A, you can use it to play an NNXT, for example, without the use of external mergers or splitters. After connecting the node CV out of the matrix to the NNXT, it behaves like you would expect. Let's add a device to show you how to manipulate its control elements. I would like to change the rate of the pulsar. It can be done directly through the input on the back, but then you will not see the knob move. The results are also slightly different, so I am going to connect through the programmer of a combinator. After selecting the pulsar in the device list, you can select an element in the modulation routing list. When you click an empty target slot, you can choose all remotable elements of the device. Then you can connect the source to the ReTrigger. Just enable the group and start modifying. Let's test value A. Both test buttons pressed will move the knob from left to right and back. When no test buttons are pressed, the random function will start. When the function is set to up-down, the button moves left to right and back. Let's also connect the rate of LFO2 and manipulate it. Now might be a good time to start naming things. The input is matrix 1. Group A1 is LFO1's synced rate. And group A2 is LFO2's synced rate. The labels stay in place when you flip the rack by hitting Tab. Also, the CV jacks are located right behind the LEDs and displays you want to connect. Right here, the LED is dimmed green and blinks bright green when a cable is connected on the back. If no cable is connected, the LED is dimmed red or blinking red to inform you that the calculated value is not outputted. It's also possible to change the labels while the device is shown from the back. When the device is folded, the LEDs still show input and output, and whether cables are connected or not. This is column A, this is CV input, this is MIDI input. These four LEDs represent the groups, and the last LED is the patch out LED. So you can see what is going on and what is connected or not. Let me show you what you can manipulate. This matrix, place this and an XT, and it sounds like this. In this case, the dirt knob is connected to the dirt CV jack on the back. So when I enable the group, the effect is affected by the amount of dirt that is now being changed by the ReTrigger. But it is also affected by the amount that is already dialed in. When the dirt knob is manipulated through the programmer, the knob starts to move and you can see exactly what's going on. I advise you to use this method, because it's way more clear what's going on. This is the same situation, but the effect is the sweeper. You can manipulate knobs, like the frequency knob. You can manipulate lists, like the stages list. And you can manipulate buttons, like the bypass on off button. Note that you have to use different values when the connection is made with the rotary input jacks, then when the connection is made with the CV input jacks. On the back panel of the ReTrigger, a table is shown to help you select the right values. First shown are the rotary values, and below you can see the CV input values. It's also possible to manipulate VSTs. The programmer has 8 CV inputs you can use. Click an empty parameter slot to select the element you want to manipulate. The VST also shows the changes. The ReTrigger is fully automatable and remotable. Right-click a control and select the proper settings. All controls can be set like this. Or select Remote Override Edit Mode from the Options menu and double-click an arrow and move a slider, for example, on your controller. Let me show you some possible input sources. The matrix has a gate out. The Kong has a gate out per pad. The Dr. Octorex has a gate output. Every time a new slice is being played, a gated pulse is sent out from this CV jack. The Rhythmic has 8 gate outputs. The alligator has three gated outputs. The sweeper has a trigger you can use. The RPG-8 has a gate output. And I forgot to mention the ReDrum drum computer that has 10 gate outs. And of course there are loads of third-party devices that have a gate output CV jack on the back. For example, the Veasy ReArranger has 2 gate outs. You can also use a player like the drum sequencer. It has 8 CV outs, and when you connect each of them, every lane in the sequencer triggers a column in the ReTrigger. So when I solo the bottom lane only, those triggers are handled by the ReTrigger. Or you can use the MIDI input of the player that is received by the combinator beneath. But the ReTrigger doesn't show any input. That's because you have to select the ReTrigger in the programmer and tick the box where it says Receive Notes. This is not set by default. Then all columns that are set to receive MIDI input are triggered. So when you add notes to any lane, also those notes trigger all columns that are set to receive MIDI input. When I solo the bottom lane, only those 4 notes trigger the ReTrigger, and after unsoloing, you can see it receives all the note triggers. You can use a ReArranger to send MIDI notes to specific columns on a ReTrigger. Here, 3 ReArranger are set to divide the incoming notes from a polystep sequencer into 3 octaves. The first ReArranger is set to act when the incoming notes are in the range of C2 to B2. Those notes are sent to out 1. All other notes are sent to out 2. The out 2 notes are sent to the next ReArranger that has a range in set to C3 to B3, and so on. Like this, the ReTrigger's columns receive pulses only when they are in the right octave. The ReTrigger is available in the recent shop. Click the link that appears right now or see the link in the description below. Thanks for watching and have fun using the ReTrigger.